Mahalo and Guten Tag, everyone. This will hopefully be my first, not playthrough, but more of a presentation of an English translation of PoPoLoCrois story. Once upon a time. There was a small kingdom known as PoPoLoCrois. Its king's name was Palo Pacapuca. The queen's name was Sonia. After many years together, a beautiful baby was born to them. They named him Pietro. People came from all around to celebrate the prince's birth. However, a sudden, deadly chill swept over PoPoLoCrois. A blizzard turned the country white, and its rivers, mountains, and cities were frozen solid. It was all the work of the Lord of Ice, who ruled over a vast realm to the north. The four powerful mages known as the Sinister Quartet by his side, the Lord of Ice besieged PoPoLoCrois. His army was frightfully strong. It would have only been a matter of time before the soldiers of PoPoLoCrois all fell. But then, a great dragon appeared, shielding the castle with his body. The battle between the dragon and the Lord of Ice went on for 7 days and 7 nights, until at last the Lord of Ice was defeated. However, before he fell into the world of darkness, the Lord of Ice seized the exhausted dragon so that they would perish together. The people of this land worshipped the dragon that had given its life protecting them, and made it a symbol of their country. It has been 10 years since that fateful day, and Prince Pietro has grown up strong and true. As the sun sets on his 10th birthday, the curtain rises on this fairy tale. This is, of course, a Japanese game translated to English. Try to have the credits below. Chapter 1, Stolen Crown. It's gonna be mine! There it is. PoPoLoCrois Castle. Here we go. Gear up, you goons. Let them have it.
Today is Prince Pietro's 10th birthday. People from all over the kingdom have gathered to bring him gifts and celebrate. But the party can't seem to bring a smile to the prince's face. The person he wants to see the most can't be there.
Everyone here is celebrating my birthday, so how come? How come I feel so lonely? I just wish I could see my mom. Never mind. Mom's passed. She's been gone as long as I have. It's been 10 years already. Alright, got to get you up to date. Pietro turned 10 today. Don't you worry, he's doing just fine. He's still got some rough spots, but the people here love him, and he's growing into a fine young man. Dad, what are you doing here? Dad, who's this lady? Why is she sleeping here? Dad, what's going on? Dad, is she? Dad, say something. How dare you hurt my dad? this little pun. Oh, whatever. The treasure's mine now. Learn some manners, get up. If you want to take on the devil king, the greatest evil genius in the world. Come back to the cotillion. PoPoLoCrois castle is shaken by a sudden terror right on Prince Pietro's 10th birthday. Self-proclaimed double king Gami Gami and his crew made off with the crown of wisdom, the greatest treasure of PoPoLoCrois. Even the king was overcome and wounded with his soldiers. The chaos this attack left in its wake continued long into the night. When the fires were finally extinguished and all the wounds buried, the long night was coming to an end. In the sky to the east, the rosy hues of dawn heralded. Are you volunteering? Oh my goodness. Here I thought of you as a mere child. But now that you're prepared to undertake a dangerous journey to save the king, leave everything to me, Prince Pietro. As minister, I'll take full responsibility for your adventure. Preparations must be made at once. Oh, that reminds me. Hey, you two, get in here. You're out there, right? These two are gone and gone. To say they are the best sword arms among our uninjured soldiers would be quite an exaggeration. However, they are good soldiers, young and full of spirit. Please take them with you. I'm sure they'll serve you well. My name is Gon. I'll serve you as best as I can. My name is Don. My blade is yours. We'll go on ahead and get things ready in the castle town. Come down to the town once you've got things ready. Well then, my friend. We're all counting on you. Please bring back that crown of wisdom. Wait. My lord, it's your rest. I am just fine. How dare you send me a draw to battle? Aye, but you see, what could a child like Pietro hope to achieve on his own? You mustn't underestimate that devil, Kami Kami. If Pietro faces his army, he's sure to be wounded in pain. Magum, spare your excuses. Pietro is not to go to battle. That is an order. Is that clear? terribly sorry, but don't worry. I'll think up another way to get back to ground. Don't fret, my prince. Just return to your room and stay put as my lord commands. You must excuse me. There's lots of